Dann rede mir nochmal.
Hallo Gottlieb Daimler.
Let's get started.
Yes.
Happy to have you on board. It's a pleasure.
Thanks. This is the EQE SUV, the fourth member of our EVA2 platform. And I would like first talk with you a little bit about the drivetrain itself.
Mm-hmm.
We have here the same e-drive system on board as in the EQE. Same e-machines and same battery. We talk in terms of energy, 90 kilowatt hours energy of the battery,
yeah,
approximately. And this car has an e-range according to WLTP up to 590 kilometers. This one is a four-wheel drive. So now we'll show you one of these very specific features we introduced with this car first, and it is the so-called disconnect unit of the drivetrain. You see here, yeah, we have here a four-wheel drive. We have both axles were steered. And the idea of the disconnect unit is whenever it is not necessary to disconnect the front axle. I need to travel a bit faster to show it to you.
Yeah.
You see now the front axle is in charge, and now we switch back to the rear axle.
Yeah.
And in terms of comfort, when the clutch opens and closes,
okay,
you feel nothing. So what does it mean? From energy consumption perspective, this brings the driver a benefit of something about 5% in real life. So we are introducing a complete new technology to optimize the energy consumption without losing any kind of comfort for the driver. Another point is the so-called heat pump. You know, now we have a beautiful weather, but you know, this winter. You know, during the winter, when you drive from home to your office, when the car is cold, it's very important to heat up the car. So we introduced with this car the heat pump as an additional feature, which reduces the energy consumption for this kind of short trips, inner city, cold temperature, less than 5 degrees, by 10%.
Oh, as an option?
No. Or
as a standard?
No, as a standard.
Okay, okay.
As a standard. We start with this car, and of course we will then bring these two technologies to our other models too.
Okay.
Let's stay with the charging system. I said we have here basically the same battery as in the EQE sedan. That means that the charging power is the same as physics. And we have here a peak performance of charging of 170 kilowatts. You see here Mercedes Me Charge on board. You see this tiny little charging stations.
Yeah.
This is our digital charging service we offer to our customer. Mercedes Me Charge, as you know, includes more than 800,000 charging stations in one system worldwide. You can use by only one RFID card, that means one methodology for a payment, and you don't need to care of different RFID cards. And also it includes plug-in charge at the Unity charging stations, which is from customer perspective very seamless. Yeah.
So it is cross Europe.
It's cross Europe, yes. Not on, the Mercedes-Benz Charge idea is not only cross Europe, it's worldwide. And of course, in Europe, we have a separate network, as in US and as in China. Of course, different
markets.
Market specific. Let's say with plug and charge and charging, if you want to drive today with this car to Hamburg, the navigation system will offer you some charging events. And takes in account the traffic situation, the weather situation, of course, your trip, and the availability of the charging station. So you are always supported to find the right charging station. And if you're on the road to
one charging station and it is occupied while driving, the system has an upload each and every 3 minutes, so it will automatically give you another solution so you can drive to another charging station.
That is great, yeah, because that is one of the big hurdles to overcome still, is the pain sometimes of charging and planning charging and having broken or occupied charging stations.
Another step regarding the charging topic is, of course, as we announced in the US, well, the CES, Mercedes-Benz will build up an own charging network.
Yes, yes.
And, you know, we have then one more additional Mercedes thing. You know, a Mercedes-Benz customer will be able to make a reservation for charging stations in our own network, which is the last step of seamless charging experience.
So you are sure you have your place reserved, there's no more stress, there's one card to take care of all charging?
In that case, you don't even need the card, it's only supported by plug and charge.
Okay.
Drive, put in, and drink coffee.
Now we would show you two additional features which are completely new and which we introduce also with the EQE SUV.
Yes.
And it is part of the Hyperscreen, part of our entertainment system. We start with Median. Dolby Atmos sound. You ready?
I am. I think. Oh. I hope.
What is with the woofers? Jesus Christ.
You know the Hyperscreen since the EQS. We always try to have some improvements, to have some tiny little features to surprise our customers. And is one of his features is the Dolby Atmos sound here in the EQE SUV. Another feature is to offer our customer video streaming.
Oh, great, yeah.
Watch Top Gun.
Sure, always, yeah.
Always, why not?
That's why, yeah, you know the intro sound, it's great. Yeah. Takes me way back.
But of course, we do have the other additional sounds here in terms of sound experience. You know, we also can offer a very specific sound experience in combination, of course, when it's dark, and you have the ambient light and you have then the sound. It's really, really cool to have that kind of experience.
It's an immersive, complete experience.
Yes, absolutely. So these are, as I said, the Dolby Atmos sound and ZYNC, for example. Yeah. These are tiny little features we wanted also to bring with as in addition to whatever we have, always have in the Hyperscreen, to offer something new to our customers. This was the chapter of entertainment and infotainment. Let's go to the chapter of the car itself. And again, of course, the energy consumption and efficiency is very important for EVs, as you know. And of course, we are very thankful that we achieved with this beautiful car a CD value of 0.25. And I would ask you afterwards to start Google and ask Google which SUV has a similar CD value.
Are there any?
I don't care. No, please don't get me wrong. It is, we are very thankful, it was hard work. But of course, as you know, the EVA2 platform has a purpose design, our one bow design, and it helps us a lot to optimize the CD of the car itself, yes. And it is very important because it's the daily support in terms of energy efficiency for customers.
Of course.
This car is our all-rounder. We introduced the EQS as a luxury sedan, then the EQS as a business sedan, then the EQS as a SUV, again luxury interpretation. And this one is our all-rounder. It's more agile, it's more dynamic than the bigger brother. This car is produced in Tuscaloosa, in a plant in Tuscaloosa, for all markets, and in Xunyi in China for the Chinese market. So we have two plants which are now currently ramp up the volume of this car in order to launch the first member of the family.
And delivery will start in the US and then come to Europe later on, or is it both at the same time?
Yeah, first in the US at March, so next month,
yeah,
and in Europe in the second quarter.
Okay.
These were the main points of this car. Of course, we have air suspension in terms of comfort. We have the steering rear axle, 10 degrees, which is one of our highlight features. We also have here on board all the cool EVA2 specific features like the Hyperscreen, like in the other models. And in addition to that, for you, we highlighted some tiny, new, beautiful things.
It is wonderful. It is a beauty.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it. When we are back, we'll show you one more cool Mercedes thing. Because this car is, of course, an off-road car. To be honest, it's, of course, difficult to describe when you're not driving. But we have implemented for the US market specific due to the regulation. In Europe, the regulation situation is different. The automatic lane change that you can change the lane, the car can change the lane automatically. Yeah. And it's, of course, a lot of fun, and it's so relaxing if you're on the highway, especially in the US, on a long trip. It's very similar to, I don't want to say to level 3 driving, but it's really, really a comfortable mode to drive a long distance.
How does it work? You initiate that you want to switch lanes and the car,
the radar system takes in account who is around you and your specific speed and so on. All the intelligence, and it's, of course, again, a part of our artificial intelligence system behind the car, which takes into account what happens around the car, and can I proceed an automatic lane change or better not. We are using artificial intelligence, and one example is the zero layer of the Hyperscreen itself. You know, you see here some shortcuts, they were created and they were pushed up to the top layer of the screen because the system takes in account which features and functionalities you often use. And this is the Hyperscreen is not only a big piece of beautiful technology, it also has a lot of intelligence inside, and this is what my personal answer would be if somebody asked me what is your opinion about digitalization. So now we are very happy to show you one more Mercedes specific thing, and therefore Max has to leave us.
Yes, I have to remove the caps.
okay.
You know, I said to you, this is an off-road car.
Yes.
And if you drive off-road, you want to see what is underneath your car.
I would like to, yeah.
Yes.
But I cannot because there's no camera. So we are driving over the blocks.
We're driving over the blocks.
Yeah.
And we show to you what is underneath your cars.
That is crazy.
Yeah. As I said, one more thing.
Yeah. Is it a real camera? Or is it a generated image in between the wheels?
It is scanned and generated.
It is scanned and it knows what was there right before. Mm-hmm. And it projects it.
Of course, we have sensors and cameras in the front. But we don't have cameras underneath the car.
No.
Okay.
So this part... In the red line is generated.
Yes.
That's crazy. Which means that the part you see here is not real time. It is an impression of what was there before.
It is nearby real time. And you don't have a delay of minutes.
No, suppose there you're standing still with this system on and something crawls underneath your car. It wouldn't show here, right?
After a few seconds. A few milliseconds.
I'm just...
you're asking.
Yeah, I'm just asking stupid questions. The technology is crazy in this car. As is the turning circle, as a matter of fact. Jesus, is this 10%?
This is 10%, yes. This is 10%.
And yet another car I really want. Thank you so much for having me.
For the pleasure.
This was the tour of the EQE SUV. Thanks for watching. Bye.